Meer as 300 mense eis nou geregtigheid. Die vermeende bedrieërs het maande lank in kantore in Knysna en Mosselbaai gewerk. Verlede week het hulle opgepak en verdwyn.
Ek het gesien van my vriende gaan soontoe en hulle geld belê. En toe ek nou sien, okay, hulle kry hulle gelde terug, toe dog ek, okay, wag, ek gaan ook belê. En toe ek nou belê, en het was nou amper tyd vir my om uitgebetaal te word, toe sien ek maar hulle verdwyn. Want hulle die 12de januari het hulle fasiliteerde gesluit en almal het begin bekommerd raak en mekaar begin kontak en sê, maar hoorie, so die mense is nie daar nie.
Na die eerste uitbetaling was die versoeking te groot om nie weer te belê nie.
On day 2, which was on Tuesday, I called again, but they were still on voicemail. So unfortunately, we got scammed.
Hulle het 'n slagoffer ondersteuningsgroep gestig.
In respect of this fraud, it was quite unique and audacious in that the fraudsters didn't operate in a virtual manner. What we're seeing with cryptocurrency and forex trading frauds is people are operating on social media, they're operating via WhatsApp, via Facebook, via Twitter. They're encouraging people to invest small amounts with virtually immediate returns. So you invest at 2,000 Rand, you get 6,000 Rand back in a couple of days. These fraudsters were different. They actually opened up brick and mortar shops where you could walk in, meet with them and listen to their pitch.
Die bedrogsake is aan die handelstak van die valke oorhandig.